Thanks for joining us here on the 2008 Apple Review, a look back at this year's news about Apple. At the annual Macworld Expo in January, a gaunt-looking Steve Jobs unveiled a much-anticipated MacBook Air to a crowd of Apple fanatics. The less-than-an-inch-thin notebook quickly gained admiration from people who were on the go, but the device does have some downfalls. There is no optical drive, no wired Ethernet port, and the price comes to close to $2,000 for the machine. In other Macworld Expo news, Steve Jobs will not be keynoting at the show in January 2009, and Apple won't be there at all in 2010, citing that trade shows have become a very minor part of how Apple reaches its customers. Introduced at the company's Worldwide Developers Conference, the iPhone 3G launched around the world in July. In the US, the iPhone runs on AT&T's 3G network, which Jobs pointed out is approaching the speed of Wi-Fi.
You can see that the 3G speeds are actually approaching Wi-Fi. This has been my experience using the phone as well. It's amazingly zippy.
While lines for the 3G phone weren't as long as lines for the original, there were issues with the activation system. Out braving the lines on release day were our friends at PC World, who got an iPhone 3G and put it through its paces with a torture test. Let's take a look.
And it is still kicking. And someone is calling my voicemail, apparently. Oh! We have damage, but it looks like it's still working. The weather in Cupertino is 77 degrees.
In addition to the 3G phone, Apple introduced the App Store this year, or a place where users and developers can share applications. They range from blogging apps to ones for watching sports or reading news, to ones that are purely for fun. At the Developers Conference, one of the applications was a collection of virtual instruments that can even play 12-bar blues. Apple opened a slew of stores around the world this year, with a few to note. The largest Apple store in the US opened its doors in May in Boston. The three-floor glass facade store is able to serve up to 1,000 people per day at its Genius Bar. The company also extended its reach to Australia, where it opened its first store on the continent. Also seeing its first Apple store was China. Located in a central shopping complex about 6 kilometers northeast of Tiananmen Square, the store featured all of the usual Apple offerings, though pricing was a bit higher than their overseas counterparts. The company introduced some new iPods this year and updated some older models. First up is the Touch, which now has a built-in speaker and volume controls on the side of it. It comes in 8, 16, and 32 gig sizes. A new Nano was also introduced, now available in 9 different colors. You'll need to turn the iPod on its side to watch TV shows and movies, but probably the coolest feature is its iPhone-like accelerometer. When you shake it, it'll randomly select a new song. But be warned, iPod users. A research study cautioned us this year about MP3 players and pacemakers. The magnets in earbuds could potentially deactivate or throw off implanted defibrillators and pacemakers, leading to palpitations or arrhythmia. Researchers suggested that those with heart devices do not store earbuds or MP3 players in a breast pocket. At Apple's Cupertino, California headquarters, it unveiled a redesign of its MacBook line with lighter and cheaper laptops. Apple calls the body design a unibody enclosure, which is the result of a new manufacturing process that starts with a 2-pound slab of aluminum. The finished product is a laptop chassis made from one piece of metal. The extra pieces of metal that were cut away during the process are recycled. The new MacBooks range in price from $1,300 to $1,600. The more powerful MacBook Pros range in price from $2,000 to $2,500. And not to forget, the MacBook Air was updated with a larger hard drive. Mac users sometimes feel invincible to hackers and viruses, but not this time. At the CanSec West Security Conference in Vancouver, this year a Mac was the first computer to be hacked. It took only 2 minutes for Charlie Miller, a former National Security Agency employee, to hack the Mac and win a $10,000 prize.
What did you make him do?
I made him go to a certain URL in his web browser.
And then?
You'll have to talk to them about something.
And then the result was?
The result was I ran whatever I wanted, which happened to be it opened up a port on his box. I telnetted it into it, and I could do whatever I wanted.
If Max getting hacked wasn't troubling enough, Apple co-founder Steve Jobs died twice this year. On CNN's iReport site, a user posted that Jobs had a massive heart attack. And in August, Bloomberg News accidentally published a prepared obituary of the Apple leader in August, but quickly retracted it. The four-page obit chronicled his time with Apple and noted his gaunt appearance at the company's Worldwide Developers Conference, which fueled speculation that Jobs was ill again. Even a powerhouse like Apple is no match for the worldwide economic downturn. It opened the year with stock shares near $200, but as of late, shares have been closing around $90. And that's the 2008 Apple Review. Be sure to check out our other year-end wrap-ups. I'm Nick Barber in Boston with reporting by the worldwide team of the IDG News Service.